Cytokine receptors are proteins that are produced on cells, and they receive signals from outside the cell and transmit that signal into the cell, and they control the cell predominantly with growth, activation of what the cells do, and they are really important in a lot of physiological processes. So there's a whole range of cytokine receptors, a little over 30, and so they have a very broad range of different actions. Some of the famous ones are the growth hormone receptor, obviously involved in regulating growth. But besides growth, it has very important roles in regulating metabolism as well as a number of other things. A lot of the other cytokine receptors are involved in regulating particularly inflammation, so important in things like rheumatoid arthritis. But many others are important in regulating blood cell growth, and so there are a lot of functions in regulating a number of different cell types. As they're involved in a really large range of different physiological processes, unfortunately they can be involved in a really large number of different diseases. So as I talked about growth hormone, obviously we can have important effects whether having too much growth or too little growth. But in other cases, so those in inflammation, as I mentioned, things like rheumatoid arthritis being very important, but things like Crohn's disease, but in the blood cell development, we can get problems with too many blood cells or too little, and when they go wrong, we can also get things like different types of leukemia and a number of other problems. Okay, so from the research from my group, we try and understand how receptors work, how these cytokine receptors transmit those signals into cells and driving their growth and their metabolism and all their actions. And of course, when it comes to diseases, we want to try and make things that can either activate these receptors or inhibit or block those receptors. And so our research has what we think has found the weak point of these receptors. And so we're using that weak point as a way to find specific molecules that can bind to that weak point to either turn these receptors on or off. And we have some now that seem to work, but just, you know, a little bit. And of course you might think, well, that's not very significant, but if you think if you wanted to fly and there'd never been any planes before, you can't make a jumbo jet the first time. You think about the first plane that ever made, it only flew a few hundred meters, so it takes a lot of funding, a lot of research to try and translate those new molecules into something that's going to end up in the clinic and be a very specific targeted approach that targets only one particular disease and has very minimal side effects. And that is the direction that my research wants to go.